Hey, honey. My tiny whoop got into Viagra again. I know what you're thinking. That's the biggest thing this hand ever held. What? Today we're taking a look at the Shendrones Squirt. Shendrones Squirt. I'm just gonna, after the Viagra joke, I'm just gonna leave that there. So you may be thinking, Mighty Thor, why do I want a Shendrones Squirt? Doesn't go fast. It kinda can't really handle wind very well. I mean, it's just loud and noisy. And plus, it makes the rest of my tiny whoops jealous. So the reason you get a, what is referred to as hashtag Cinewhoop, the reason you get that is because you wanna get some video that you wouldn't normally be able to get on a drone. This is like a moving dolly, if you know what a dolly is. If you don't know what a dolly, no, I don't mean Barbie. Stop it. Put your Barbies down now. You're all excited for a second, you and your brony friends. Like, hey, he's talking about dollies finally. I knew he was one of us. No, I'm not. And for the record, blow-up dolls are not the same as Barbie dolls. Not that I would know anything about that. I'm just stating it for a fact. Okay, moving on. Hang on, I had to get a drink. Hang on. Lovely. Not a paid endorsement. Neither is this video about the Shendrones Squirt, but best ginger ale ever. Don't even argue with me, just stop it. Give you a little story while you're sitting there with your Barbie doll and hugging it and loving it so much. This is the way this worked. Once upon a time, I'll put a little video down here. There was these people out in Japan. They said, you know what we'd like to get? A dolly shop that moves more than about, you know, 6 feet at a time. We like it to go like 100 feet. Well, that's a lot of track if you know what a dolly is. However, they got one of these. Well, not specifically this, but something like this. They took it and flew it on a lovely flight. I think this was an advertisement for some band. All I saw were pretty Japanese women. That's all I saw. It was great. Some kind of band or some models or I don't know. They were beautiful. So I just watched the video like this, because I don't see many women. I guess you could have guessed that, didn't you? So then comes along Paul Nurkler, who must have been looking for Japanese women somewhere along the way, and he saw this video and said, wow, wait, it gets better. Then Paul Nurkler, Nurk FPV, sees Bionico and then the Shendrones, and I think he actually, I may have get the story up a little bit different, but who cares? In the time of Trump, I can say anything I want and it's true. So somewhere along the way, he collaborated with Andy Chen, who runs Shendrones, and said, hey, can we get something to fly like that video with them hot Japanese chicks in it? And you're like, and he was like, I think I can do that. And then, you know, the rest is history. So I saw that video and went, I want one. In true Nurk fashion, let me tell you what this is not. Technically, when winds exceed 10 miles an hour, maybe 15 miles an hour, this should not be flown outside. Why? Because it's windy, and this is ducted, and winds don't hit this thing right. That's why. Why do you have to question me? If I just say something, believe me. God, you people are so mean to me. I don't even know why I do this. Okay, I'm sorry. I had a bad day, a little indigestion. I didn't mean that. Yes, I did. No, I'm sorry. No, really, didn't. What this is for is largely, I want to say 95% indoors, unless you have a nice calm day where there are no winds, and then you can take it outside and fly it all you want, like I'm doing here today. However, I have to tell you, yesterday I was in some pretty heavy winds, and unfortunately that recording, something happened to it, and I flew this with some different props, and it was just all over the place. It was ba-zoom, 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 like that. So I was like, whoa, hey, whoa, 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 hey, whoa. You know, and then I finally landed it because I was like, wow, the winds are too tough here. It comes Sunday, which is today, and it rained a lot, and we have some storms moving through the area here in Florida, and the winds aren't that bad. Today I flew it in 10 to 15 mile an hour winds, and except for a couple little exceptions or quick moves that I think might have to do with the PID settings more than the wind, this reacted a little bit differently, but not much. I mean, I think there's one or two spots in the video you'll see where it does that. I am gonna whip through a build video because I yak a lot, and I just took up almost half the video by yakking and trying to make you people smile, which really I should focus more on being more serious, I think. Nah, that wouldn't work for me. As far as what I've got in it, before I do the quick build, because I use pictures and you can stop the video anywhere you want, we can mount the GoPro. First of all, this whole unit is a GoPro Shendrones Squirt. It's a GoPro because it comes with the mount when you buy it, about 90 bucks. It is not a very thick frame. You're not gonna bam into a bunch of stuff and expect this to survive, although if you're going slow and you hit something, that's different. It's like a tiny whoop. It just go boink, you know? Although this is a little bit bigger than a mosquito. This thing probably weighs anywhere between 300 to 500 grams. I don't know, I didn't weigh it. You know why? Because I don't carry scales with me, man. What do I look like, a produce person or something? No. But when you're flying it places, let's say you're indoors, people should be aware that this is gonna hurt a little bit if you get hit with it. Not much, not like a drone going 90 miles an hour. This is only gonna be cruising around about 5 to 10 miles, but this has some, 5 to 10 miles an hour, but this has some, you know, has some weight to it. So, you know, I mean, even this would hurt, the GoPro, or this wouldn't though. That doesn't hurt at all. I don't feel it. Ugh. It's like I'm scratching my head or something. I don't feel a thing. In my never ending quest to try and find different angles, different views, different things to film with, when I saw this, I thought, boy, that really solves a lot of problems for me. I can't, you know what, sometimes I look at that and I don't know which way it's going. Okay, anyway, back to this. So this solves a lot of problems because it gives you that you can do a nice big crane shot, or you can do a nice big dolly move that'll go like 5 miles down the road if the battery will last that long, then you come back again. And it goes nice and slow and it's steady. That said, let's get into the build. Starting with the build video, this is the way my Shendrones frame was packaged. Here is the ESC and the flight controller. They were hobby wing, the link will be down below. It was a very nice setup. I was quite impressed with the way the board was constructed. In this portion of the video, I'm measuring everything out and I put the stack in. You can see the nice cable connections right there. I'm using a Foxeer Monster Pro Mini. I'm also using Brother Hobby 1407 3600 KV motors as recommended by Mr. Paul Nurkler. One thing that I didn't like about this Hobby Wing board was I had to actually kind of pair everything up to the video connection. I mean, it was nice, but a little extra more work. Who cares? I did it. Now connecting up the video, you see I had to solder some stuff in. I don't usually like to do that, but you can't do anything about it because nobody makes the same damn plug for any one video, camera, or whatever. They gave you a nice capacitor. They gave you two capacitors. I took the larger capacitor and I put it down in the bottom here because that's not gonna get knocked around or anything because there's a top plate that goes over that. Now you can see I used a Foxeer Stubby. It's the Foxeer Lollipop Stubby V2, MMCX to a SMA connector. I hooked up the crossfire in the TX-RX1 and the finished build kind of looks like that. The VTX is on another platform that I had hanging around. I put it on there so because it was smaller than the stack. That was a 20 by, it was smaller than the stack. This is a 20 by 20 VTX versus the 30 by 30 for the flight controller and ESC. And there's the finished build. I actually turned out, changed those props to something you'll see. I probably already previously said it in the beginning of the video. I took the DYS 3045s because they fit in there perfectly. I had one problem, which is not, I wouldn't say it's the fault of anyone. How would Andy Shen know that I wanted to put a lollipop on here? I originally liked to use the Lollipop MMCX. I have as I said before in the build, I have an FX30 in here, which is very tiny, small, and I would like to put a Lollipop in here, but the Lollipop would only extend out to here, which isn't very good for reception. So I wound up getting a Stubby with an MMCX to SMA adapter. That worked out well. The other thing I'll have to revisit is where I put this. I think I need to put it more up in the middle here. That's one of my mods I'd make for this. I put it out the back thinking, oh, they're all gonna reach back there. Well, only half my batteries reach back there and another section do not. Now, all the parts that I talked about and listed come from the original build that Paul Nurkler did. I don't care, I'm a copycat. You know, sue me later. I'm gonna fly one of these things, and if he did a good enough build, why can't I just copy it too? You know what? You can copy mine. And then you can copy of a copy of a copy. And then you're a clone, and the next thing you know, they're tearing you up for parts. And your eyes are being pulled out, and then all of a sudden you don't eat food anymore, and it's what the hell, man, I did. Sometimes I just, right off the edge. All told, I want to say I spent about $300. I also want to point out that I tried different props on this. These are the DYS 3035s. It's written on here somewhere. Wait, yes, these are the 3045 propellers. I tried cutting some. You can see a picture here from 4-inch down to 3-inch, and it really didn't go too well for me. I mean, I cut them pretty good, but I didn't really like how loud they were as compared to these. These are a lot quieter. And I also had gotten some other propellers that work pretty well too, that I'll keep around in case I need them. But for right now, I think these DYS do it the best. And I didn't have to cut them or modify them or anything 3045, 3065. I wouldn't get too crazy, because you really should have bullnose propellers in here because of the way this is built. So don't try to stick your Brandy's 3075 supercharged propellers that she used on her Batwing when she was Batgirl, okay? Just do what I say and get these, and you'll love me better. As far as firmware, I'm running the latest Betaflight 3.5.3, and I kind of tuned it to what Paul Nerkla had put up on his website. All these links, everything, you follow that Metal Monkey Dance down below, and you can join in the bliss that is my life right now, because I know you want to be blissful or blisterful. I'm not sure what you're into, S&M, blister, blissful. It's pretty much the same thing, no matter what you do. If I forgot anything to do with the build on this or the parts or anything, if I had some other thoughts, I will put them down below as well, so you can go read and have some fun, you and your Barbie doll sitting there reading together. Maybe you'll read the Barbie. I don't know. I don't know what you do in your private life. I don't care. My goal for this thing is to put two cameras on it, or put the 360 camera on it. Now, the 360 camera would require a GoPro mount in front. The 360 camera really doesn't weigh a lot, and I would get both views backwards and forwards. I think that's my greatest game right there. If not, I'd stick the battery here and a camera here in the back, and then go on from there and see what I do. I could put two GoPros on, I could put a GoPro and a run cam, I could put a GoPro and a bowl of soup if I wanted to. If I wanted to take somebody some food, I put it on the back of that, serve it, float it next to them, they take it. This thing like could be used for anything. So that's gonna do it for the Shendrones Squirt. He called it a squirt because it's only 160 millimeters this way, and it zips right along like a squirt, like when you go boom, and it shoots it out there, right? Or you cough up a loogie and you go squirt. Mighty Thor from the beautiful city of Tampa, Florida. See ya.